am so beautiful. Don't you think I'm beautiful? And Fox said, I think you're being a little bit of a show-off, aren't you? You know, you're nice looking, but there's a lot of others that are really as nice looking as you. And he says, oh no, I'm the best, I'm absolutely the best looking person. And so Fox thought, I think I'm going to have to teach Bear a lesson about what it is not to be quite such a show-off. And so he said, are you hungry? I'm always hungry, said the bear. I'm always hungry. He said, all right, but it was winter. So let's go out onto the ice. So they go out onto the ice, and there's a hole right there. And he said, if you sit there, and if you dip your tail down into the hole, he said, you're going to catch a lot of fish, and then you'll have lunch. And Bear thought, well, I can do that. And so he sits down by the hole, and drops his tail into the hole like this. And after a while, he starts to get a little bit, oh, boring. He's getting a little bored just sitting there, you know, wagging his tail in the hole. And a little while later, he falls asleep. And Fox comes over to him and looks at him and says, he is fast asleep. We'll just wait and see what happens. And so a few hours later, the ice hole froze over, trapping the bear's tail that he was showing off about. And so, quickly, Fox steals away, and he picks up a rock, and he comes back, and he flings it as hard as he can at the bear, and he goes, Bear, wake up! And of course, scares him, and the bear leaps to his feet. His tail's been frozen, and it's snapped off. And that's why bears to this day don't have any tails. And that's why it's not a good thing to be a show-off, because somebody will come and put you down. And that's what he did to teach him a lesson. It had dark, rich bark and green leaves and fruit and all kinds of things on it, and he just thought it was the most stunning thing. Well, his wife had this great vision, and she said to him, husband, I have had a great dream, and it means for you to pull up the tree of life, leaving a big hole in the sky. Well, gosh, he didn't really want to do that because, I mean, the tree was just beautiful. But he realized the importance of his wife's vision, and never underestimate the importance of your dreams. They teach you many things. And so he wrapped his arms around the trunk, and he pulled, and he pulled, and he pulled as hard as he could until finally he pulled it up, leaving a big hole in the sky. Well, his wife leaned forward. She was holding onto the tree, and she leaned forward, and all she could see below her was water as far as the eye could see. And she looked down, nothing. She looked a little farther, and she slipped, and she fell through the hole. Uh-oh. Now she's coming towards the water. And all of the swimmers, the whales and the otters, all the swimmers and looked up and they saw her coming and oh my God, we have to do something. If she lands, she's going to drown. And so two swans said, it's okay, we'll go and get her. And the two swans unfurled their beautiful white feathers, their wings, and they floated up and they caught the woman and they brought her down onto the water where she stood on their backs. Well, of course, that couldn't go on for long, right? The swans were going to get a little tired, don't you think? And she was going to need to step on shore. And so the big swimmers decided they would go down to the bottom of the ocean and see if they could bring up a little bit of earth for her to stand on. Well, the biggest ones tried, the big blue whales and the orcas and the sharks, they all tried, but they couldn't get down there. So eventually all the animals tried until they were all lying on the top of the water and they were exhausted. And finally, little muskrat swam over. She says, this little tiny animal, little muskrat. And she said, you know, I think I can do it. But the rest of the animals said, well, they were too fluked to laugh at her. And they went, well, you might as well try. We haven't done it. It took her quite a while. So down she went. And finally, she got a little bit of earth in her paw. And she came up and she said, I have it. What will I do with it now? And Turtle swam over. And he said, put it on my back. I have a big back. And so she did, and immediately the land started to grow, and the standing people, you know, those are the trees, rose out of the earth, and the plants and the vegetables and the grasses as far as the eye could see. And that's why the Haudenosaunee people refer to North America as Turtle Island. So have you ever seen Turtle Island?